the day, NFL attendance. The policies are being left to each individual team. It is going to be based on city and county, you know, restrictions, etc. I believe, and the reason why I put this in our show topics today, because it was just announced like an hour before our show, I believe Chris is correct on taking all of the overs. Every team has the opportunity now to set whatever they want their attendance to be. They can have full stadiums if they want them. They can set 50%. But if you got the opportunity, why not just go ahead and open the whole thing up and, hey, we'll put a little waiver on the back of the ticket. If you buy this ticket and you show up at the game, you are responsible for whatever happens to you.
That's right.
I think you're right.
I think that's going to happen. Now that we've said we're going to let the owners decide if they want fans or not, now this is a horse of a different color.
Yes.
Now Chris is going to NFL games.
Michael said, so California teams are screwed.
Oh, no. I disagree. I'm standing pat on. I think these NFL owners that are in the cities that they play in have enough power, have enough leverage that they will dictate laws.
Yeah, I agree. I agree 100%. The people that have the money in this country, they dictate the laws. Yeah, they make the rules. And that's what's going to happen here. You'd be hard-pressed to find anybody that doesn't believe that we're going to have, you know, full stadiums to start this thing off in August and September. I just
believe it. I don't know what this virus is going to do between now and then. I know this. Butts are going to be in many, 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 many seats in the NFL.
Michael said Newsom will find a way to screw it up. We can bet on that.
I don't know that he's going to have an opportunity. I think there's a pretty big swinging dick in there called Stan Kroenke that's going to say, listen, you're going to do what I tell you to do.
Oh, yeah. I mean, you got the 49ers, you got the Rams, and you got the Chargers. That's just those three. You know, you got other ones across the entire country. You got two teams in New York that basically play in New Jersey, right? So,
and they do play in New Jersey. Not basically, it is New Jersey.
Well, and then you've got Buffalo that's actually in New York. You've got, I mean,
Buffalo's the only one in New York.
You've got all kind of different stuff. I'm curious to see, but I really think that they're just going to open this thing up and, hey, if you want to come in, we'd be glad to have you. Listen, I think that's what it's going to be.
I agree. I could not agree more. I think it's going to happen.
Michael said, do the Chargers really count, though?
They count. Yeah, they count. Now, see, this is where they're going to be like them and the Redskins are going to be able to get some woke points because they're going to say we're only going to allow a quarter of the people to come in. When
fact of the matter is, it was only going to be
historically, they only have a quarter of the people there. But then I got social distance them. They're going to push them all down to a lower bowl so they can at least have it look decent on TV.
Damien said, I don't think we need to open the stadiums yet to the public. It's too soon to do that, especially with the protests still happening. We're still months away, you know? Yeah. We still got all of July, or the rest of June, all July, all of August, and then we'll see. Michael said the Chargers have to be happy, less fans from visiting teams. Yeah, I suppose that would be a good thing. Yeah. But as far
the
as
the only
like,
winner in this would be the Chargers.
Pretty much. Damien with saying that he doesn't think the stadiums need to open, especially with the protests still happening. I don't know
how those things are related.
I don't understand that either, but I also don't think that we're still gonna be having protests in 2 months.
But even if we are, I don't think those things are related.
Why should the people that are going out protesting be allowed to be out in the street in groups and other people not be allowed to go into stadiums? Like, especially outdoor stadiums.
Well, I mean, what if the people protesting want to go to games? I mean,
yeah.
I mean, they have lives outside of that. You're talking about 2 hours of a week.
Yeah. I mean, we're not talking long.
For 8 weeks a year.
Hey, Ben wanted to correct you, by the way. He said the Redskins won't have any woke points. Just check their team name.
Well, okay, that is correct. That's true. That is correct. That they will not have woke points. They lose a lot from that. Snyder will find a way to try to spin this to a positive.
Oh yeah, Michael said, open it up. If you're worried about COVID, just stay home. Yeah, now I can see them opening it up, and everybody is required to wear a face mask or something like that. But they're going to find a way to get people in the stadium. Yeah. Like, I'd almost guarantee that. So, all right. Is there anything else that has happened that we need to touch on today or that we want to touch on?
No.
All right. That works for me. Shorter show than usual today, but that's all right. If you guys would so kindly hit the share button, let all your buddies know about the show. Make sure you are subscribed on the podcast and at any of the different live locations. Go over and check out the website, winningcureseverything.com. All of our picks, previews, podcasts, videos, social media platforms. Michael said, thanks, fellas. Hey, thank you. Thanks to everybody that jumps in the chat every day. You drive the show. You make it worth coming in and watching. We have a blast with y'all every single time. We will see y'all again tomorrow. But first off, take care of yourself. Take care of each other. We'll see you tomorrow. Thanks for checking out Winning Cures Everything. If you want to keep up with us, hit subscribe on YouTube or your favorite podcast app. Visit the website at winningcureseverything.com, or you can like us on Facebook or follow us at Winning Cures, at Gary WCE, or at Chris B. Giannini on Twitter. Share out the show, leave a nice review, and make sure to comment and tweet at us.